stance is going to be a wide stance. It is not going to be short. It should be almost 3x to the shoulder. So my right toes slightly in, my right heel out. I'm pressing the foot down. I'm keeping my left knee bent. The knee and the ankle are in one line. Thigh is parallel to the ground, chest open. Next inhale, I'm going to raise the arms up. The first variation is going to be, I'm dropping my left elbow on my left thigh. I'm raising my right arm up and looking up. If you're very, very comfortable here, what can be next is, just drop this left palm down on the mat. Press the palm down, focus on opening the chest to the front, to the side, and then raise the arm up. Keep pressing, remember we keep pressing the foot down, I'm not bending my this knee. Press the foot down, open the chest, and look up. 15 seconds, we're going to stay there. Remember, the priority is to focus on the breath. Breathe in and breathe out. 10 more seconds. Keep breathing. Keep breathing. Almost there. And slowly come back up. Straighten this left. Flex the toes in. Tuck the toes in. Right goes to the other side. Bend the knee. The stance remains same. I'm pressing this foot down now, my left, raising my arms up, inhale. Again, the beginner is going to be variation that I'm dropping the elbow down, I'm raising this arm up and looking up. Or if you're comfortable, let's drop the right palm down completely, but focus on opening the chest first and then raise the arm up. If you're not comfortable looking up, anyone? Look down. A few more seconds. Or keep looking up. Keep pressing the left foot down. And now focus on the breath. Now breathing deep. It's a little uncomfortable here. But focus on the breath. A few more seconds. And slowly come back up. Right toes in. Let's move to the front of the mat again. Beautifully place the right elbow outside of the knee. Make sure you're keeping the hands in Namaste Mudra. You can stay there, or if you think you're comfortable enough to lift the right knee up, please go ahead. Parivritta Parshvakonasana. Make sure if you're lifting the knee up, straighten the right leg. Gazing up to the ceiling, to the sky, and a couple of more seconds. Find the balance. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. A few more seconds. And the same way coming back as well. Drop the knee down. Arms to the chest and come back up. Inhale. Same thing is going to be repeated from the other side. I'm dropping my left knee down, lifting the chest up, and left elbow now completely outside of the right knee. Lift the left knee up and twist. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Find the balance, gazing at one point, and you'll easily find the balance. Focusing on the deep and long breaths. Pressing the left elbow to the right thigh or the knee. And slowly drop the knee down, lift it up, and go back to the center. Everyone. just lie down on the back.
Perfect.
So my knee to my ankle, they're in one line. So I'm keeping my palms next to my thighs, next to my hip region. I'm pressing the palms down and lifting the hips up as high as we can. Push it up, push it up. And once we're there, we're going to stay there for a few seconds. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Deep and long. Keep pushing the hips higher. Deep and long inhalation, exhalation. A few more seconds. One more push and hips little higher. And slowly dropping the hips down very slowly, easily. Catch hold of this. Pull this in first. Inhale there. And exhale, head up. See if you can touch the nose or the chin or the forehead. And stay there. Keep breathing. Remember, focusing on deep and long inhalation and exhalation. A few more breaths, keeping the right leg active too. Next inhale, drop the head down, and exhale, release the leg. Beautiful. Now all together, both the legs, both the knees. Grab it, pull it in, inhale there. Exhale and head up. Try touching the nose. And stay there for a while. Slowly inhale, drop the head. Exhale, release the legs. Beautifully done. And we're done with the asana sequence. Now that we're done with the asana sequence today, I hope you're feeling stronger yet calmer after the asana practice. And moving to the last but not the least, shavasana. All we need to do is just stretch the legs out. Legs may be mat width apart and just lie down comfortably. Toes relaxed on the sides, palms next to my body and facing upwards. Fingers naturally curled. Eyes softly closed. And surrendering ourselves.